We begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the memorial of Saint Francis Xavier, a priest and a missionary. We look up to him as our example of zeal and passion in embracing our mission in life. Join us as well as we thank the Lord for the gift of priesthood. Join me, Father Aldwin, Father Paul, and Father Tom, as we thank the Lord for his faithfulness and his kindness. For us to be less unworthy to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us implore the forgiveness by which we are all redeemed and saved. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the preaching of Saint Francis Xavier won many peoples to yourself, grant that the hearts of the faithful may burn with the same zeal for the faith, and that Holy Church may everywhere rejoice in an abundance of offspring. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On that day, a shoot shall sprout from the stump of Jesse, and from his roots a bud shall blossom. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, a spirit of wisdom and of understanding, a spirit of counsel and of strength, a spirit of knowledge and of fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be the fear of the Lord. Not by appearance shall he judge, nor by hearsay shall he decide, but he shall judge the poor with justice, and decide aright for the lands afflicted. He shall strike the ruthless with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. Justice shall be the band around his waist, and faithfulness a belt upon his lips. Then the wolf shall be a guest of the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with a kid. The calf and the young lion shall browse together, with a little child to guide them. The cow and the bear shall be neighbors. Together their young shall rest. The lion shall eat hay like the ox. The baby shall play by the cobra's den, and the child lay his hand on the other's lair. There shall be no harm or ruin on all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the Lord, as water covers the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse, set up as a signal for the nations. The Gentiles shall seek out, for his dwelling shall be glorious. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
Justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
He shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
May his name be blessed forever, as long as the Son his name shall remain. In him shall all the tribes of the earth be blessed. All the nation shall proclaim his happiness.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. Please stand.
Behold, our Lord shall come with power. He will enlighten the eyes of his servants.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus rejoiced in the Holy Spirit and said, I give you praise, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows who the Son is except the Father, and who the Father is except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Turning to the disciples in private, he said, Blessed are the eyes that see what you see, for I say to you, many prophets and kings desired to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Like Jesus in the Gospel, we can also say that we can rejoice in the Spirit. Not only because we are gathered here today to celebrate life, the grace of God, but more so we can truly rejoice in the Holy Spirit because of the grace of priesthood. It is the Holy Spirit who ordains and configures the heart of men to become priests. 2 years ago, on this day, these 4 men were ordained to the priesthood. And it was really a gratuitous blessing from the Lord. Priests cannot own their priesthood. It is always a free gift from God. And we can say that the priesthood of your ministers right here is forever, not because of their own doing, but because of God's immense love for them. Because their priesthood is attached and springs forth from the eternal priesthood of Christ. And this thanksgiving humbles us, especially these 4 priests who are celebrating their anniversaries today. Father Biel, Father Alduin, Father Saber Paul, and Father Tom. My dear brothers and sisters, let me share with you 3 important lessons that we can learn from the gospel for today. Jesus would tell us that he revealed these mysteries not to the learned and wise, but to the childlike. Young men become priests not because they are wise and learned or intelligent. Yes, they studied for a long time in the seminary, but in reality, that is not the qualification to be ordained. The primary qualification to be ordained is for you to have an intimate relationship with God. That's why the Lord will say you have to be childlike more than becoming intelligent, wise, and learned. Because you must first accept God as your Father. You must first learn how to embrace God because he has adopted you as his sons and daughters. That's not just for us priests, but for each and every Christian. We are saved, we are blessed, not because we know God with our intellect, with our mind, or with our heart. We know God because we allowed ourselves to be consumed by his immense love. Be childlike more than being intelligent and wise. The second thing that we can learn from the gospel is that this is the gracious will, gratuitous will of God that is given in our gospel. It is because of her gracious will that we were revealed the mysteries of God. What does that mean? We do not own the revelation, the mysteries God has entrusted to us. Our life is his gift. It is an undeserved privilege. Lahat ang meron tayo, hindi natin pwedeng may pagmalaki sa iba. Hindi natin pwedeng may pagmalaki sa harapan ng Diyos. Ang pagkapari namin, hindi namin pwedeng ipagmayabang because it comes from the grace of God, from His gracious will. It is undeserved. But even though we are unworthy, even though we still have our human frailties, God chooses young men to be ordained to be His ministers for His church. And the third reminder that we can draw from the gospel is that we can learn the blessedness of sight. Jesus would tell this to his disciples, "Behold our God, for I say to you, blessed are the eyes that see what you see." Our eyes become blessed. Why? Because we allow ourselves to be enveloped by the love of God. Kapag nakita natin yung sarili natin na nakadepende sa Panginoon, na nagtitiwala sa Diyos, na tinatanggap ang ating Ama bilang sandigan natin, bilang pinanggagalingan ng lahat ng bagay, our eyes become blessed. And we will see everything as graces coming from God. Even though sometimes we fail, even though sometimes we are broken, we will see those moments as moments of grace. Father Viel, Father Aldwin, Father Tom, and Father Xavier Paul were ordained during the season of Advent. And because of that, we can say that they are Advent priests. But not just solely because they were ordained during this season, but because they accompany us in our preparation for the coming of our Lord in our lives. Not just remembering the birth of the baby Jesus, but they help us prepare for the coming of the Son of Man, the Judgment Day. That's why that is the one of the primary and essential aspects of our ministry, our priests, to be teachers of faith, to be caretakers of the mysteries of God. And because of that, we are able to guide the people of God, not because of ourselves, but because of the Spirit of the Lord being bestowed upon us. And that is the very message of the first reading for today from the prophet Isaiah. We rejoice of the Holy Spirit because He has given us the power to be instruments of peace, of love, and joy. That's why in the first reading, Isaiah would also say that when the Spirit comes to us, the wild ox will be a guest of the Lamb. Our natural tendencies to become selfish will be restrained because of the Holy Spirit. Our natural tendencies to repeat our mistakes will be restrained also because of the help of the Holy Spirit. That's why we continuously trust in God, because our sustenance comes from Him. It comes from His immense love for us. My dear brothers and sisters, let us continuously pray for our dear brothers who are celebrating their presbyteral anniversaries today. May they be Advent priests for us. May they help us be prepared for the coming of our Lord Jesus in our lives. May they continuously inspire us through their ministry and through their identity as teachers of the faith. Let us all stand.
The Father reveals the mysteries of the kingdom to the little ones. Let us pray to our God who shows such love for the small and weak people. We bring all our needs before our Heavenly Father, confident of His loving care. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. That those who serve the church as bishops, priests, and ministers may proclaim God's kindness and love, especially to the poor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That civil leaders may give attention to the needs of the humblest citizens. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That children may get to know God by our teachings and examples. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may find comfort and healing in the care and concern of those who nurse them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may enjoy the everlasting happiness in the kingdom of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, we lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass, as we also lift up to the Lord our own intentions, our prayers for one another, and for all priests, that we may continue to be an instrument of God's mercy, of God's graces and love to all of, to everyone. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, your Son promised to give us rest when overburdened. Grant that we may always respond to his guidance and strengthen us to be instruments of his peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, beloved brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, these offerings we bring you in commemoration of Saint Francis Xavier, and grant that as he journeyed to distant lands, out of longing for the salvation of souls, so we too, bearing effective witness to the gospel, may with our brothers and sisters eagerly hasten towards you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Francis Xavier, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthened her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
of the Lord.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Francis Xavier, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Sa pamamagitan ni Kristo, kasama niya at sa Kanya, ang lahat ng parangal at papuri ay sa iyo, Diyos Amang makapangyarihan, kasama ng Espiritu Santo, magpasawalang hanggan.
As children of our loving and gracious Father, we call on him as Christ taught us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May your mysteries, O God, kindle in us that fire of charity with which Saint Francis Xavier burned for the salvation of souls, so that walking ever more worthily in our vocation, we may obtain with him the reward you promise to those who labor well in your harvest, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kindly be seated. Before I impart the final blessing, let me humbly express my gratitude to the following. First and foremost, my gratitude goes to God who called us, for maintaining His kindness to us, to this servant of Him, to these servants of Him, whom He knew very well who has a lot of weakness. At sa pagkakataong ito, samahan niyo po kami magpasalamat sa Diyos sa biyaya ng 2 taon sa pagkapari. Salamat po, Panginoon, dahil mabait kayo sa amin. My gratitude goes as well to my brother priests here with me, celebrating with me our anniversary, my batchmates, Fathers Aldwin, Father Tom, Father Paul, and Father Oni, our seminary classmate. He is from the Diocese of Iba, the priest in charge of the Ina Poombato Shrine. Kaya ipagdasal din po natin ang kanyang mission doon po sa Zambales. And also Father Jaime Marquez, director of the Our Lady of Guadalupe Minor Seminary. Together with him are the grade 10 seminarians of the seminary po, na minsan din pong napastol ko po as their seminary formator. Salamat po, fathers, and salamat po sa inyo, boys. I wish to thank the kindness of my present family, the Manila Cathedral community, to the kindness of my boss, Monsignor Rolly, to the staff, and to our generous servants of the Manila Cathedral. Salamat po sa inyong kabaitan sa akin. To friends, families, relatives, and dear ones who came all over today, lalo na po sa mga nag-half day, nag-leave, at gumising ng maaga. Kaya abot-abot po ang aking pasasalamat sa inyo pong kabaitan ngayong araw na ito. Kilala niyo po ang inyong sarili. To my family, to Mommy, Daddy, Kokoy RC, and to the new bundle of joy na ngayon ay tulog, si Rio po, nagdun po siya, no? Salamat po sa kabaitan ninyo dahil gumising din kayo ng maaga para sa akin. And to all of you, to our regular on-site and online cathedral community mass goers, at sa lahat po, salamat po sa pagpaparamdam ninyo ng inyong kabaitan at sa kabaitan ng Diyos sa pamamagitan po ninyo. I have been repeating kabaitan or kindness for many times. After King David wrote Psalm 51 as his words of pardon to the Lord, life did not end by just saying, "Lord, I am sorry. Have mercy on me, O God." There was Psalm 88 or Psalm 89 afterwards, a psalm that assured David, "I will maintain my kindness to him, and forever will my promise stand firm." Akalain man natin natapos na ang laban dahil nagkamali tayo o sumablay tayo, huwag po nating kalimutan, mabait ang Diyos sa atin. And I am very sure that this gift of the priesthood is but God's everyday call of and sign of His kindness to all of us. We might fall short, I might fall short, I might grow cold, I might find this ministry lifeless, but God will never stop reminding all of us, "I will maintain my kindness to you, and forever will my promise to you stand firm." Salamat po sa pakikiisa niyo po sa amin ngayong umaga. Nakadalawang taon na po kami sa awa at sa kabaitan ng Diyos. Please all stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you forever and ever.
Amen.
May He let His face shine upon you and be gracious to you forever and ever.
Amen.
May He turn His countenance towards you and grant you His peace forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.